तमिलनाडु राज्य और ऐतिहासिक शहर चेन्नई सदियों से भारत और चीन के बीच हमारे सांस्कृतिक और व्यापारिक आदान प्रदान का साक्षी है। पिछले 2000 सालों के अधिकांश कालखंड भारत और चीन दुनिया की प्रमुख आर्थिक शक्तियां रही है। अब इस शताब्दी में हम फिर से साथ साथ उस स्थिति को प्राप्त कर रहे हैं। एक्सलेंसी, पिछले वर्ष वुहान में हमारी इनफॉर्मल समिट से हमारे संबंधों में इंक्रीज स्टेबिलिटी और फ्रेश मोमेंटम आया है। दोनों पक्षों के बीच स्ट्रेटेजिक कम्युनिकेशन बढ़ा है। वुहान स्पिरिट ने हमारे संबंधों को एक नया मोमेंटम और ट्रस्ट दिया। आज के हमारे चेन्नई कनेक्ट से दोनों देशों के बीच सहयोग का एक नया दौर शुरू होगा।
It is my great pleasure to come to this beautiful city of Chennai at your invitation and have this second informal summit with Your Excellency. I want to especially thank you for the fact that since the moment that we arrived, we have been immersing or overwhelmed by this kind of gracious hospitality and thoughtful arrangements that the Indian side has made. Me and my colleagues have felt that very strongly. And we are really overwhelmed by your hospitality, and we feel that Mr. Prime Minister, the Indian government, and the state of Tamil Nadu, and the people here cherish friendly sentiment toward the Chinese people, the Chinese government. And we really feel your sincere welcome to us during this visit. So this will be a very memorable experience for me, for us. Mr. Prime Minister, as you said, you and I have engaged in candid discussions as friends. In this heart-to-heart discussions on bilateral relations.
they also spoke about other developmental priorities. In particular, there was some discussion on trade-related issues, on economic issues, on trying to identify areas for investment that the two countries could to encourage, and also on how to enhance the trade volume and the trade value. And in this also obviously included the issue of the trade deficit that exists and the unbalanced trade that exists. Some of the other topics included the challenges that both countries face on account of terrorism. There was an acknowledgement that both countries are very complex, they are very diverse. Both leaders said that these were large countries and that radicalization was a matter of concern to both, and that both would work together to see that radicalization and terrorism did not affect the fabric of our multicultural, multi-ethnic, multi-religious societies. And there was a general sense that both leaders had that this was a common challenge that we face and that we will work together to overcome it.
सांस्कृतिक विरासत की छटा बिखरती हुई शोर मंदिर का परिसर आज इतिहास के पन्नों को टटोल रहा होगा जब इसका वैभव अपने चरम पर था, जहां आज की शाम चीन के माननीय राष्ट्रपति श्री शी जिनपिंग और भारत के प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी आपने यहां साथ साथ अनौपचारिक बैठकों के ये बड़े ही खूबसूरत और यादगार
सिंस बोथ आंचल एंड अभिषेक रेफर्ड टू जम्मू एंड कश्मीर आई वुड लाइक टू स्टेट क्वाइट कैटेगोरिकली दैट दिस इशू वाज नॉट रेज्ड एंड नॉट डिस्कस्ड And therefore, there's no question of my making any further comments on the matter. In any case, the Government of India's position, as expressed publicly, is very clear. This is a matter that concerns the internal affairs of the country. Both sides agreed to consolidate strategic communications, to enhance it at all levels, to talk and share about any issues that we have, to build mutual trust, including between the militaries. Fourthly, we agreed that there would be greater understanding shown on trade relations and on our sensitivities relating to trade. We would try to find a way forward in addressing the trade deficit. A new mechanism at an elevated level would be created in order to talk about trade issues. Fifthly, we both agreed that it was important to deal with the challenges of terrorism and radicalization in an increasingly complex world and where our own societies were diverse and both leaders were leaders of countries which were not only large in terms of area and population but also in terms of diversity. Lastly, but not the least, there was a new focus on people-to-people relations, an understanding between both leaders that the public in both countries. There have been nearly 5 hours of discussion and quality time that the Prime Minister and President Xi Jinping of China have spent together. Most of this was one-to-one, with the exception of the half-hour cultural program. I'm sure all of you have seen the visuals of the tour that was given by Prime Minister of the World Heritage Site at Mamallapuram. And at this stage, I do want to compliment the state government of Tamil Nadu. The Prime Minister himself has complimented the state government of Tamil Nadu for the excellent arrangements and work they have done. President Xi Jinping himself has also said that he was overwhelmed by the welcome that was given to him at the airport and the arrangements that have been made for him during his stay in Chennai. The visuals, as you have seen, the walk around that Prime Minister and President Xi Jinping did in the three separate sites at Mamallapuram, they reflect the personal rapport that the two leaders have built over the two informal summits that they have held, the first one last year in April and the second one which is ongoing, as well as 17 other meetings that they have held since Prime Minister took office in 2014. President Xi Jinping and Prime Minister during that tour of the monument spoke of the historical and trading links between the southern part of India, particularly between Tamil Nadu under the Pallava and Chola dynasties, and the eastern coast of China, particularly Fujian province. They both referred to a port city called Quanzhou in Fujian, where recently Tamil inscriptions and fragments of architecture reflecting a possible temple built by Tamil traders in the 12th century has been discovered. President Xi Jinping also said he was aware of this. Both leaders have discussed how we can actually enhance knowledge in this aspect of our bilateral relationship. There have been nearly 5 hours of discussion and quality time that the Prime Minister and President Xi Jinping of China have spent together. Most of this was one-to-one, with the exception of the half-hour cultural program. I'm sure all of you have seen the visuals of the tour that was given by Prime Minister of the World Heritage Site at Mamallapuram. And at this stage, I do want to compliment the state government of Tamil Nadu. The Prime Minister himself has complimented the state government of Tamil Nadu for the excellent arrangements and work they have done. President Xi Jinping himself has also said that he was overwhelmed by the welcome that was given to him at the airport and the arrangements that have been made for him during his stay in Chennai. The visuals, as you have seen, the walk around that Prime Minister and President Xi Jinping did in the three separate sites at Mamallapuram, they reflect the personal rapport that the two leaders have built over the two informal summits that they have held, the first one last year in April and the second one which is ongoing, as well as 17 other meetings that they have held since Prime Minister took office in 2014. President Xi Jinping and Prime Minister during that tour of the monument spoke of the historical and trading links between the southern part of India, particularly between Tamil Nadu under the Pallava and Chola dynasties, and the eastern coast of China, particularly Fujian province. They both referred to a port city called Quanzhou in Fujian, where recently Tamil inscriptions and fragments of architecture reflecting a possible temple built by Tamil traders in the 12th century has been discovered. President Xi Jinping also said he was aware of this. Both leaders have discussed how we can actually enhance knowledge in this aspect of our bilateral relationship. The two leaders had another conversation of almost 90 minutes on a one-to-one basis, and that was followed up with talks at the delegation level between the two delegations, followed by prime ministers hosting a lunch in honor of President Xi Jinping and his delegation. So in all, the two leaders have had 6 hours of direct discussion on a one-to-one basis. One of the important understandings that the two leaders reached, therefore, was that a new mechanism will be established to discuss trade, investment, and services. This will be at an elevated level. From the Chinese side, it would be the Vice Premier. His name is Mr. Hu Chunhua. From the Indian side, it will be the Finance Minister of India, Srimati Nirmala Sitaraman. The two leaders had a fairly long discussion on people-to-people relations, and both Prime Minister and President Xi agreed that we need public opinion in both countries to broad-base the relationship that we have between India and China. And to this extent, under this rubric, a number of issues were discussed. President Xi Jinping has invited Prime Minister to China for the next informal summit. This will obviously be at a mutually agreed time, and the Prime Minister has accepted this invitation with pleasure.
Chinese companies to invest in India and hopes that India will provide a more fair, friendly and convenient business environment for Chinese companies to operate in India. For a long time, the imbalance of trade in goods between China and India has been one of the factors troubling the economic and trade cooperation between the two countries. To make it clear, China has never deliberately pursued trade surplus. China is fully aware that balanced trade is sustainable and beneficial to both sides. Over a long period of time, China has taken a series of measures to reduce the trade imbalance in goods and made positive progress in promoting the import of agriculture products from India to China and accelerating the registration and approval of Indian pharmaceuticals. Not long ago, Olanzapine, owned by Dr. Reddy, India's second largest pharmaceutical company, passed the Chinese consistent evaluation successfully and was listed in the National Procurement Catalog of China.